Hello, I'm Rick Kurzbergen with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension. Today we're going to talk a little bit about forage quality and forage testing. So it's really critical for livestock producers to know what they're feeding their animals. And it's critical to understand the importance of forage quality because it makes a big difference in terms of the amount of supplemental feeds you might have to feed your livestock to get the production level you want out of them. So hay and silages are the predominant way we preserve forages in Maine. And it's critical to get samples of these and get them tested for their quality. And we look for nutritional parameters that are going to be important for us as we balance a ration. So in Maine, hay can be determined by looking at it in terms of quality. And when we look at it visually, we can see differences in color, and we can see differences in the amount of stem to leaf. And that gives us some indication of quality. So here's a bale that's second cutting hay that has a high amount of leaf material and not quite so much stem material. Whereas over here, there's a bale, obviously it's not nearly as green, but contains a lot more stem and less leaf. So this tends to be of less nutritional value than this bale. But really the key to finding out how true the nutritional value is to take a sample of it. What you need to do is to take a hay core sample or a sampling tool that's going to give you a representative sample of the whole lot of feed that you're going to feed. Ideally, what you want to do is prioritize your feed into different groups or lots. And you can see that this farmer has labeled some of his bales so you know where the field was, that the feed that forage came from, and the day it was harvested. That way we can characterize and prioritize feeds according to when and where we want to feed them to different livestock. To take the sample, you would draw right through the center of the bale and drill through. Then you would detach the core sampler and then place the sample in a clean plastic bucket. And it would produce a sample for you that's going to be representative of the whole bale. That way you're not being judgmental when you take the sample, and you are getting a good representative sample of what your animals are consuming. You want to take multiple samples from many different bales, combine them in a plastic bucket, and take a subsample of that for sending to the lab. Now, as you heard when I took that sample of the cordless drill, that it takes quite a bit of power. So often we suggest people use a hand brace instead. So the technique for taking a sample out of a large bale would be similar. We want to core through the center, and you want to take a sample that's going to be representative of what the animals eat. So for this situation, we'd make a hole in the plastic, and this is silage, it needs to stay anaerobic, and then we would hand drill through the center of the bale. Again, we would detach the sampler and we would empty that sample into a clean plastic bucket and then take a subsample of that to send to the lab for analysis. If you're using silage like this, you want to make sure that you seal up that hole when you're finished. So you could use tape and seal it up so it stays anaerobic and will not deteriorate over time. If you're sampling fermented feeds, it's important to make sure that it gets to the lab in the correct condition, meaning that you want to sample that feed early in the week and get it in the mail so it doesn't sit over the weekend waiting for the lab to pick it up. So take a sample early, and if you need to, you can freeze it and mail it in a frozen state. It will not affect the nutritional quality of the feed being tested. So for many farmers, a lot of the grain companies that you service or you buy grain from will do some of these samples and analysis for you. If not, you can take these samples by yourself and send them to either a commercial lab or a university-affiliated lab. You can have a variety of analysis done. The most oftenly used analysis is one called NIR, which stands for Near Infrared Reflectance Spectroscopy. And that NIRS analysis is very quick and very accurate. Forage quality is key to a successful livestock operation in Maine. Knowing what you have for forage resources and how to match that with purchase concentrates are an important part to a profitable livestock operation. For For more information about livestock resources, please visit the University of Maine Cooperative Extension website and look under Livestock Resources.